I am a slow learner. How should I get over it? I'm a slow learner. Thank you for asking that honest question. Slow learner. Okay, first thing first. Are you a slow learner in everything? Or are you a slow learner in certain things? Because we're not meant to be good at everything, right? Like, for example, I'm good at like science, psychology, but I'm not good at history. I'm not good at like art. I'm not good at those things. You can call me a slow learner in art. So am I a slow learner in general? No, not necessarily. I'm not a slow learner in science. So you have to pinpoint where your weaknesses are and be specific with it. Are you a slow learner in everything or just a few subjects in your study, in your studies? So you have to identify, be specific, because when you generalize your weakness, you're gonna feel very bad about yourself, when in fact, in reality, your weakness is not generalized. Maybe you are excellent in skill-based things like cooking. I mean, you could cook, you can learn to cook really fast. You're a fast learner in cooking skills. You're a fast learner in fixing cars, for example. You're a fast learner in that. I can't do that. That's not my thing. So you have to identify where your weaknesses really are and try to identify where your strengths are, because I don't think you can be a slow learner in everything unless there's a biological deficiencies happening, like you have low IQ or things like that. That will be a case where you have generalized slow learning. But if you are only a slow learner in certain things, it doesn't mean that you are a slow learner in everything. So that's something that I would dive into as my first step. Second step is, there's nothing wrong with being slow. There's nothing wrong with being slow. The thing about us is that we think that everything should be instant and fast. I mean, instant gratification is one of the things that we obsess over, and it's understandable because it's instant, right? Instant noodles, instant this, instant that. So we like things to be fast. I mean, even internet right now, right? If you go back to 10 years ago, you can't bear the internet speed back then because you're so used to things fast right now. So we like things to be fast. We like the results to come right now, right now, right now, right now. But again, you have to step back and look at life in a bigger picture. It's not a race. It is not a race. If you're a slow learner, take more time to learn. And I know, by me saying that, you might be thinking, oh, senanglah cakap, nanti bapa aku kata apa, nanti jiran aku kata apa. People will talk. Whether you're a slow learner or a fast learner, people will talk. Whether you do the good thing or the bad thing, people will talk. People will talk regardless of what you do. So, if people are going to talk anyway, better you do something that is right by you, right by your principles, right by your life, and also according to your abilities. Because you can't go beyond what you're capable of doing. You can't, right? You have limitations. Everybody has. I have my own limitations, you have yours. So you have to understand that about yourself and put a realistic expectation on yourself based on your capabilities. If you need more time to finish your degree, take more time. Because you're not capable of finishing it earlier, just like your friends. And don't compare with your friends, because your friends have different circumstance than you. So, don't compare with other people. Live your life based on your capabilities and have your own expectations of yourself. Because it's nothing wrong with being slow. There's nothing wrong. Really. It's okay. It's not a race. It's a journey. The main point is you get to your destination. Whether it be fast or slow, you get to your destination. And it's kind of good to remember the story of the rabbit and the turtle. You know that old story, the rabbit and the turtle racing, yeah? Just because you're fast doesn't mean it's good. Think about it.